If you have an interest in yoga, then India is the place for you. To take a yoga teacher training course in India is a great privilege. These practices have been practiced for thousands of years in this environment.
It's a very unique and rare opportunity.
If somebody is really interested in learning yoga, they will have an incredible experience.
It's an amazing process that we all go through that are part of this training, because we go through a process too, along with the students.
This training is going to push you to ask fundamental questions about who you are, how you see the world, and is that bringing you happiness?
When you come to Jivamukti class for the first time, you're confronted with a whole bunch of new ways of looking at things.
Perhaps what makes a Jivamukti student different is they have a sense of adventure. They tend to be very curious. They're willing to put aside their habits and societal norms and step out of the box. Take a chance. Explore.
Jivamukti gives me everything what I'm looking for, like in terms of bhakti, music, yoga postures, scriptures, all of these.
The Jivamukti curriculum is very open-ended in the sense that we expose students to a lot of different ideas of what yoga could be.
We teach yoga philosophy, we teach anatomy, we teach Sanskrit.
What is the position of the consonant?
What we're doing now is we're looking at bodies, we're understanding bodies instead of understanding generic instructions.
If you do a lot of backbending, it will stretch the muscles that we were talking about so they get more relaxed, so you're easier to use them in a daily life.
According to karma, everything has a cause. So if we want to trace back the cause of enlightenment, it would be compassion. How you treat others will determine how others treat you. How others treat you will determine how you see yourself. How you see yourself will determine who you are.
There's magic in this curriculum. I know for a fact that it has recalibrated and rewired how I want to live my life.
I didn't even know that it would be possible to learn as much as we have in that amount of time. I think I've surprised myself, and I think all of our classmates have surprised each other just how far we've come in that month, you know? It's really quite cool to see.
Jivamukti has five tenets, and at the Govardhan Eco Village, they practice all of those five tenets. And when we're here, we just kind of merge in with the practices that are already going on. So it's a very supportive environment for the Jivamukti method.
It's like this oasis in the middle of rural India.
We're not only in India here, we are in an ashram. These teachings are being studied and practiced day after day by the people who live here.
What Rana Swami is doing here, trying to make positive changes in the world, is very exciting to me.
Govardhan Eco Village, for the past several years, has been striving to provide a prototype of alternatives for natural, holistic, compassionate living.
Jivamukti Yoga is a path to enlightenment through compassion for all beings. When you come here, you are in good company.
It's been such an intense and well-planned out experience.
This is what is shown to us when we see the imbalance in the body.
I'm very surprised by how quickly we became this group of people that just works together. We just became this organism that is connected.
Once you go through this training course, you will have friends all over the world. You become part of this worldwide satsang, which is changing the world for the better.
We are from all over the world, from every continent. We all have unique challenges while we are in the same path of understanding who we really are.
I think it's a very transformational period in people's lives. It allows for a community. It allows for really authentic connection.
I've just seen people blossom and come out in this very glowing, happy place.
The yogi has always been someone who is striving to live in harmony.
Let us chant with a prayer for peace, for happiness, for love within ourselves, within all the world.
The essence of humanity is really our spiritual nature, wherein we could live in harmony with nature, we could live in harmony with other living beings of other species.
We're teaching people a new paradigm on how to live on this planet. And it is a paradigm that is based on unconditional love and compassion for all beings.
The most important need in this world are exemplary leaders, because they set the standard within the world all around us.
If there was one thing that I would hope that a student would take from this teacher training course, it would be the knowledge that they can make a difference in this world. All the knowledge, all the technique is worthless unless your presence can enhance the lives of others.